Now, Deputy Seamus Healy, on behalf of the Greens and the Social Democrats.
Margot Leskian Corla, Taoiseach. South Tipperary General Hospital is a very progressive, forward-looking and efficient hospital, but there's a huge problem with lack of bed capacity at the hospital. Simply put, there's just not enough beds to cope with the number of admissions at the hospital. And this is a problem that's accepted by the hospital management, by the regional health service executive management, and indeed by the South West Hospital Group management. The figures are actually shocking. In the year 2011, we had 750 patients on trolleys at the hospital. In 2016, there was a six-fold increase to 4,419 patients on trolleys. Today, Taoiseach, in the height of the summer, on the 11th of July, there are 22 patients on trolleys in the corridors of the hospital. And if that's the case today, what in God's name is it going to be like in the winter and autumn months coming up? And of course, we know what it's going to be like. It's going to be like chaos, as it was last winter and the winter before and the winter before that. The hospital, Taoiseach, is bursting as it seems. It's operating at 130% capacity overall in the hospital, while the medical department is operating at 150% capacity. The preferred option of everybody for solving this problem in the medium term is a 40-bed inpatient modular stroke hotel type unit of accommodation. And Taoiseach, we've had numerous ministers at the hospital over the last number of years. We've had Minister Riley, we've had yourself, and in October last we had Minister Harris. And Minister Harris said on that occasion that that the situation was utterly unacceptable. He said a solution had to be found, and he said that we would have a decision before the end of the year. But Taoiseach, we're still waiting for that decision. So the question I have for you today, Taoiseach, is will you personally take this matter up and deal with this situation at the hospital? Obviously, there is absolutely no privacy for patients on trolleys and corridors. The staff are under huge pressure at the hospital, and as I said, the hospital is bursting as it seems, and it's awaiting approval to this 40-bed unit. And I'm asking you here today, Taoiseach, to ensure that that unit gets approval urgently, and that happens as of today. Cormorgan.
Just looking at the trolley figures from this morning provided to us from the HSE, shows that there were 272 patients on trolleys this morning compared to 373 on the same day last year, so a reduction of about 100. Obviously, I appreciate that if you are one of the 270 patients on a trolley or a family member of any patient on a trolley, that's no good to you because of the enormous distress and inconvenience that it causes, and the very difficult working conditions that our staff in emergency departments have to endure. But a reduction from 373 this year to 272 this year, or a reduction of over 100 year on year, is quite significant. I've been to South Tipperary General Hospital, and it is certainly a hospital that's in need of very significant investment. Like a lot of hospitals in the country, you can see the new part, which is very much up to standard, and you've got the old part, which very much is not. And at the moment, the Department of Health is conducting their bed capacity review, which will establish how many additional beds we may need across our acute hospitals. Of course, building new hospital blocks and new hospital wings takes several years. Even going through planning, tendering and construction, you could be talking 3 to 4 years before new blocks come on train. So in addition to that, Department of Health is working on proposals to provide temporary accommodation in a number of hospitals, the like of which you've mentioned already. Of course, it's not just good enough to provide temporary accommodation, you have to be able to staff it as well. And we did find this time last year difficulty staffing all our beds. But that proposal is now being worked up by the Minister for Health, and we'll see if it's possible to put it in place later on this year. One point I would make, and I think it is a point worth making, And I'm taking these figures from the Irish Nurses and Midwives Organisation, who produced figures for patients on trolleys in the first half of this year. And those figures were very interesting. They show an overall increase across the country, but huge variations from hospital to hospital. In fact, in Beaumont Hospital and Connolly Hospital, those patients had the lowest numbers on trolleys since records began, and in St Vincent's, the second lowest. Yet two of those three hospitals got no additional beds whatsoever, whereas some hospitals that did get additional beds actually disimproved and disimproved considerably. And what that does demonstrate to us, and we should all acknowledge this as politicians, as people who make decisions on behalf of the public, just providing more staff and more beds is proven not to work on its own. Good clinical leadership and good management is just as important, if not more important. So we need all of those things, because constantly putting more resources, more staff and more capacity into a system that isn't well led, isn't well managed, isn't going to be enough.
Your reply is absolutely disappointing and indeed unacceptable, because as you well know, and as the HSE well knows, as the hospital management knows, as the South West Hospital Group management knows, the situation at South Tipperary General Hospital is absolutely atrocious. There's an absolute lack of bed capacity at the hospital, accepted by everybody. And we've been promised, I think this is maybe the fifth year that we've had various ministers and ministers of state promising additional beds at the hospital. It's time now to bite the bullet, because the patients attending South Tipperary General Hospital are entitled to good quality hospital services, which they are absolutely not getting. And I understand, Taoiseach, that a senior medical professional from the South West Hospital Group did a forensic analysis of the bed capacity at the hospital and has accepted that 35 to 40 additional acute beds are absolutely needed urgently at the hospital. I believe that report has gone to the HSE, and that the HSE at senior level are now sitting on that report. And I am asking you here today to ensure that that report is acted upon, that report is made public, and that the go-ahead and approval for beds at South Tipperary General Hospital, not in the matter, not nationally, not anywhere else, but at South Tipperary General Hospital, where there is an agreed and accepted necessity for additional beds. Thank you.
Taoiseach, to respond in one
minute. I'd say, of course, one of the most important things that you have to be able to do if you do additional beds is to staff them. And we are hiring more staff. 700 additional nurses will be hired this year alone, allowing us to open beds that may be closed temporarily, and also also facilitate patients being discharged more quickly out of beds, just thus allowing them to be used by more patients and to have faster turnover around beds. The National Bed Capacity Review is not completed yet, and we do need to complete that. I don't think bed capacity reviews can be done in isolation, because hospitals have overlapping catchment areas, so it does need to be done on a national basis, but I'm told that's very far advanced. I did mention earlier, though, that providing new blocks, new hospital wings, can take a number of years. There's a new one just opened, for example, in Galway, providing 75 more beds, a new emergency department and a new block in the Leven building in Limerick, just opened in the last few months. A new emergency department and acute floor in Kilkenny just opened in the last few months. But all of those things took many years to plan and build. So even if we approved additional hospital blocks now, it could take a number of years to build.
The
temporary accommodation can provide capacity quickly and under pressure hospitals. That is being actively considered by the HSC and the Minister at the moment, but it does need to be worked through.
Thank you, Taoiseach. That concludes questions, leaders' questions.